Good evening. Welcome to Now and Together Industry Edition. And we are which is our very special weekly event. And today we are talking to our community and we are traveling to Japan. So it's a very exciting point that to section want to inspire you and giving to all the community of Linear Pelle community several types of inspiration coming directly from Japan. So today we will talk about Japanese consumer culture, and we have a very unique conversation with this special guest, which we talk about fashion, lifestyle, sustainability, and also retail. So let me start to introduce lady first, Mrs. Akiko Nemoto-san, Sustainability PR. Welcome.
Hello. Thank you for having me today. My name is Akiko Nemoto. I'm living in Tokyo, and I am Sustainability PR. I'm basically doing the PR, and I focus on sustainability.
Thank you, Akiko. And I also ask to my guest to repeat your name correctly because I always make some mistakes. Thank you, this. And then let's go to our today guest, Shinichi Shuto-san, the founder of Brand New KK. Konnichiwa.
Thank you, Orietta. So my name is Shinichi. I'm a founder of the Brand News, which is a marketing and a communication company in Tokyo. We do the marketing PR the services that are such as the development and strategic planning and organizing events and for clients. Also, you know, so I'm teaching at the Bunka Fashion Graduate University as a professor. So thank you.
Oh, wow. So thank you. Thank you very much. And then let's move to Shigeki Tanaka-san, the founder of PINS Marketing and Communication. Welcome.
Thank you very much, Orietta. And thank you very much for the participant for today's webinars. I'm Shigeki Tanaka. I'm founder of the PINS and specialize in digital marketing and communications.
Wow, wonderful. So we are ready to start our travel. And it's really a travel right now. So we are connected between Italy and Japan. Let me say Milan and Tokyo. So it's a wonderful experience today. And let's go now inside of our topic, because I like it to say, to tell our community that we prepare this kind of conversation, discussing about what's going on now. And we like it to investigate inside of the Japanese local consumer dynamic. So we knew that Japan live in the lockdown, and now we have some revenge, or let me say, of the virus. So there are several things that are going on. But what is happening right now in the underground, inside of the layers of the Japanese consumer cultures? So want to be the first. Shinichi first?
Sure. So I think that, you know, the biggest dynamics how Japanese, you know, so the where are the local customers that are changed. So probably, you know, so the these, you know, so the where a couple months. So one is that the people start thinking that, you know, so the where are more like the essential values when they purchase something. So that means either you know, so the where are they start thinking about data, you know, sort of, well, what this, I need this one, but I don't need this one. And they, so, you know, well, maybe after, you know, the coronavirus, so, well, Japanese people, so that, well, maybe, you know, so that, well, they purchased what they don't need. But after coronavirus, I feel like, you know, the people start, sort of getting more like either minimalism, and they just, you know, sort of will get purchase sort of what they need, what they really need in essentially. So that's how I feel.
Yeah, so you're talking about minimalism, and I like it because I want to jump inside of one of the concepts. Minimalism, less is more, sustainability. I just took this picture that was talking about timeless. How this timeless concept is growing in a certain way in their shopping experience, for example.
Maybe me or you, you are talking to me? Okay. All right. So the way, how they change because, you know, they spend more time, you know, so that living in Japan, I mean, living in the house. So actually, and well, because, you know, so that, well, they spend more time to the, at home, and they, what they need, you know, so that, well, for actual life, you know, so that, well, living in the house. So it's different. So they don't have better, more like a social life. They don't have better, you know, you don't need to go to the, you know, sort of outside. You don't need to meet people. You don't need to meet people. So you don't need to, you know, dress, you know, sort of well, you know, sort of. So actually, you know, the life, you know, style has changed. So that for many people, so the last couple of months, I believe. And they, that's why, you know, so that, well, they start, you know, they, I'm pretty sure they spend their, you know, the much money so that on something else, but they are focused on the, you know, the talking about the fashion. So I think, you know, so that, well, they spend less money and they more simple thing.
Yeah. So now I want to make a question to Shigeki, because Shigeki is more involved, of course, in also in the department store. I show you some pictures. So it's something like how people are experiencing department store shopping, because we knew that department store is one of the key points where people used to spend in a previous life, so if you spend time. What's going on in the department store now?
I think before talking, in explaining about, I think experience of department store that is, you know, like offered. I think, you know, before this COVID crisis, I think there was a big movement in Japan, like switching from mass marketing, because I think in Japan, you know, even luxury brands that was like consumed like, you know, mass products, like you can see, you know, like everybody, every girl's having a similar kind of the Louis Vuitton purse and wearing something similar. And if there is a trend, you have to follow the trend. That was very, how should I say, obsession of, you know, Japanese fashion in quite a moment, I think, that the experience in Japan. But I think especially among the younger generation and also, you know, like older generation who experienced, you know, bubble economy in Japan, I think they're shifting their values, you know, back to, how should I say, I can't say back to the roots, you know, because as it is previously explained a little bit, I think Japanese people prefer simple, sophisticated things and not having too many stuffs. and having enough and less is more, that was the beauty of Japan for quite some moment of the history. But actually that we experienced this mass marketing and the mass consuming in like eras, but I think we are coming back to our roots in a sense. And thinking about department store, I think from the very first moment of the department store, I think the value they were offering for Japanese people and how Japanese people appreciated department store was like a window to something new, some new world that you cannot discover by yourself, but specialists, that are buyers, merchandisers, specialists, very educated specialists from the department store. They collect all over the world, collect from all over the world, and introducing to Japanese people. And when Japanese culture was open to the Western culture, you know, that was definitely the window which is offering something new all the time. So it's like, you know, I don't know if it, this word is common or not, but something like Wunderkammer in the museum. It's like something you can discover very, very strange things and something new to inspire yourself. But the department store itself also, you know, by the time when Japanese people experiencing this kind of mass marketing, they have changed. But since department store has been very center of Japanese trend and Japanese consumption, so they were very, very reluctant to change. Somebody like Isetan department store, they're offering, try to, you know, like offering something new and something interesting, not just by the name of the brands. But this movement was very slow. But because of this COVID crisis, people cannot go to department store, and department store, they were very reluctant to the web platform and challenging something new. But now, you know, Japanese people are really, how should I say, open to this new world that everybody can offer something new, something the Japanese people was expecting from department store is actually can be offered from the web platform. So department store has to, you know, like consider how to, you know, change their strategy, their reluctant attitude to the web, and their reluctant attitude to change, because that huge building is not necessary anymore. That people discovered already.
Yeah, so I show you also this picture. Here we are in Ginza, Ginza 6. So are you saying that a department store that in Japan, in Tokyo, were so appealing and attracting people, getting inside, experience. This is the picture that talk about artistic installation, everything was incorporated. So now they have to switch everything online, even for luxury brands?
No, I think, you know, they have to, you know, they are now facing the, you know, reality. They really have to think much, much deeper why they need to have this big space. Because before, you know, like without any appealing, if you have a big store, department store in Ginza, people come without any effort. Of course, you know, like to maintain the, you know, sales. Of course, I don't say there was no struggling. Of course, there is struggling. But the issue is, you know, it's not, you know, after this COVID, it's not about web versus real retail shop. Online platform versus, you know, like this department store. So I think they have to, you know, like this, you know, web platform is must. And plus what they can offer, especially appealing people to come and experience something that only possible by physical contact. So that is a challenge they have to face from now on, I think. And this was accelerated by this COVID crisis, I think.
Yeah, so we assume that, because we always think, were thinking that Japan is so advanced in technology. And technology, the top of the top. So, but I guess And now you are saying, oh, it's something they have to do because they are not prepared. So they are not prepared, but means they are not prepared for which generation? All Japanese generations, or you can make a difference between generations that they can use technology?
I think the issue is maybe in a way, Japan is very advanced in transportation, very advanced in experiencing the city in a very clean way. So even the richest people, they can take easily public transportation and visiting the such stores. There's no mental hurdle to do it. So in some for example, developing countries, they are more aggressive on integrating such new technologies for sales, etc. Because luxury, for the luxury retail, because they the rich people, they don't want to be stuck in a traffic jam. They do not want to exhibit themselves in front of the public audience. They do not want to risk their security to enjoy the shopping. Therefore, it was crucial to integrate the technology in luxury retail. But in Japan, in that sense, everything was so comfortable. And therefore, I think department store didn't really facing luxury, industry didn't really face the actual necessity for the web. And actually for them, even web, it's not about, how open to the technology, but actually it is about, even for them, using the web technology sometimes looks like cheaper or cost cut in a sense. That was kind of attitude until now.
Okay, very interesting this part. But Shinichi, you was talking about that people started to go back in the store, like in department store, and how they are facing, what they are buying, which is their reaction. So when they buy something, you told me, for instance, that they start to go in the department store, that they buy in a different way, maybe more or maybe less.
Right now, I think, department stores in Japan, they are open, but they have less customers right now. So, but there are the people visit and they come to department stores. So that they are purchasing something. So that's why the sales wise. So it's are getting better. That's what I heard.
Yeah. So you mean that when they go inside of the store, they purchase. So this is
yes.
Not-
yes. Yes, definitely. Yeah, right. They purchase.
Interesting this. Maybe was it also the online way to prepare them and to give more information to them?
Yes.
Very interesting. So now let's go to the next slide because I want to involve another aspect. I found to the time out, time in Tokyo a few days ago, exactly is the edition of July, September, that they were talking about the future start with you. Join Tokyo, adopting a greener lifestyle for better future. So, and what's impressing me to see all the presentation of this kind of, way to be sustainable and live in a sustainable way. So which was not new because we already heard before, we were always thinking about this. So Akiko, what is happening now in sustainability? Which is the mood?
Yes, now as Shigeki-san and Shinichi-san already told that, people, their mind is start changing more like a simple way, and also lifestyle And what we are having, what we are buying is changing at the moment. Now, also now I'm working with the environmental activist and who is Mr. Takemoto. And can we show the picture?
Yes, I want to show you. Look at this.
Yeah, this is the environmental activist. He is here. He's actually, he was CEO of a company, but he quit his job. And he started being an activist. And he's searching for the sea all over the world for a long time. Now he's really, really actually famous for, you know, between activists. And what he's doing, people start following him because he's talking about the plastic problem and, you know, the nuclear plant problem, which we have a lot. So this is people start following him. You know, before people were just like Instagrammers, bloggers, they always following other people who are really fashionable. But now people start following these kind of people more, you know, especially like for me, yes.
This is interesting. So this means that also the mindset of the consumer is changing. So it's not only following people, they are just suggesting product and spending, and like Shigeki-san said at the beginning, he was saying as a previous, many people were going to shop because they have to follow trends. So now this is a kind of new incorporating a different types of thinking, which is more authentic in a certain way, and also learning more.
Because yes.
And I like it. So now I want to share with the community another picture that we love it to show. Akiko, what is this?
This is one of my clients who are making ghee. Do you know ghee? Like everyone know ghee? Like
everyone. Yeah. Some of
like this is kind of butter, but it's really, really pure fat, you know, which we need our body. This is really, really pure. And basically we get from overseas. We don't make it in Japan, but my client, they start making in Japan. Also the field is like a grass fed, you know, they are having like a grass fed field and cows, you know, the cows eat grasses all, you know, whole year. And we didn't have it, but now we are going to have it from this September. They are going to sell. So which is, I think it's stunning idea that, you know, people make by ourselves. We don't need to import.
So, okay.
Yes, this is a great idea.
So this means that local products are coming very important. I remind that Shinichi, maybe we can talk with Shinichi. He was talking about localization action, like companies, I don't know, Muji or some brands, they are doing action for localization. What does it mean local for Japan now? This is an example in food, but of course can also be explaining other different things.
So localizations in Japan. So I think you know, so that in Japan, you know, so the market is segmented, you know, so the very small. So that in each market, you know, so the where are their needs. I mean, the consumer needs. So has been changing last maybe probably 10 years. So that's why I think in Japan, so the where the Uniqlo and they even Muji, they are big companies, but they started adapting to the needs sort of people living where, even in the area.
It's interesting. So can I also assume that looking at this picture make us feeling that authentic material, the truly authentic material, could be the winner, can have more successful stories. So what about if I show you this picture that I took in Japan? So, which is a supernatural and ladder. Because in our community, we have material company, we have ladder companies. What do you think about these types of message, how they can appreciate more, or they want to appreciate in a different way? Shigeki, what do you think?
You mean like this message of the youth?
Yes, the message of the youth, or the message of the young generation, or the generation that follow the sustainability. I think we have all the process from ghee to authentic materials. Which is your opinion?
I think, you know, like basically, you know, like as a philosophy of Japanese people, I think originally we didn't have a big frustration about, you know, accepting a used product. Actually, we see more values for something, you know, like by the hand to hand with to the another people, that is handed to another people and descended from, you know, like time to time. We see a lot of values in that history. So that is, as I mentioned to you in a previous comment, I think, you know, younger generation, people start to, you know, like appreciate those like aging and also the potential history, which is, I think, you know, this famous store now in the center of the Tokyo in Marunouchi and also in Omotesando. This Pass the Baton is one of the very, you know, famous stores, which is like collecting the such, you know, like used products. And it is, you can say it's like a secondhand shop, but actually with the story of the original owners, they introduce new, you know, like items, and people appreciate, and people actually very happy to discover something new and discover such stories and, you know, feeling sympathy on those like stories and purchasing the products. So that is quite a big change in happening now. For example, Pass the Baton once like offered by, you know, they discovered a very old, you know, like textile from the bankrupted factory. And that is very, you know, fish carp, you know, like designed Japanese traditional, you know, like, you know, celebrating materials, which is very colorful and bright. And so they made, you know, like a non-brand, just work with, you know, different artisan using all the textile, make the bag. And people appreciate more of such products than Louis Vuitton or Dior, you know, like those brand logo. That is a change happening in Japan.
Very interesting. So, but now let's ask you another thing. So, because this is an evolution of what we said, what about made in Italy for the Z generation in Japan? Because we were talking about sustainability, activist, authentic and local and storytelling, no branded products. But we knew that these are elements from Italy. But what about Generation Z? Shinichi, what do you think about this?
Okay.
For all of you.
So. Gen Z, well, I think, you know, not only in Japan, but globally, Gen Z prefer more sustainability things, and they also they, you know, sort of like either kind of the relaxing, you know, the style of fashion, and they also I think, you know, they see that the qualities sort of in fashion. So, and also I feel like the Gen Z's parents generation, so their parents generation, so must have purchased a lot of Italian products. So at the time, so the way made in Italy is a kind of the, you know, so the prestigious and it's a kind of the, you know, the symbol of the high quality goods. So that's why, you know, so the Gen Z, their kids' generation, so they must know about the Italian brands and products. And I think, you know, so they feel like a very positive image to Italian, so the made in Italy, Italian made. So, and then now, you know, as we discussed, so in the world, so the more sustainability and they more like the minimal minimalist, so the more like the social goods, so that all they you know, things that people start feeling needs. So the that's why I think, you know, so the well for Z generation, Generation Z, so the in Japan, so the they, you know, the prefer the made in Italy products.
So you mean that if the made in Italy product, it's more connected to sustainability and the genuine stories, Generation Z could understand, it could appreciate more. So now I'm asking to Shigeki, so because it's the most high tech sometimes. What about, this can be the picture of our Generation Z, and they live all day long online. So what do you suggest to Italian companies that they want to talk to them and they want to express to them this kind of stories, authentic stories, hidden story in a made in Italy, no branded products?
I think this picture is like, you know, illustrating very well about the change of the fashion after the COVID crisis. I think like we are having now as a webinar, but I think people doesn't need to go out and spending more time and purchasing more, you know, like clothes like this one, spending most of the time with the phone or like iPad or like PC, that it's you know, situation happening in now. And answering to your question, I have a little bit different view compared to the Shinichi-san's opinion. I think in Japan, Italian brand has a very big, you know, like value historically, but that was consumed a lot by the, you know, consumers. And thinking about Generation Z, I think they do not have much respect in artisans' work of Italians, but they know Italians more through the brand name. And thinking about, you know, like Italian brand, I think sometimes they feel it's boring. For example, like in Akiko-san showed, like something like ghee made in Indian product, Northern European design, you know, there are something, you know, like people always looking for something new. In that sense, Italian brand has certain fans, communities in Japan. But when we are talking specifically about Generation Z, I think they are quite flat. They do not purchase products because it is made in Italy. Mm-hmm. And they are purchasing product because, you know, showing a lot of respect to, you know, like artisans' work of Italians. It's not by that way, but it's only by design, by brand name, and by, you know, like how much it is appealing to them. Hmm. So in that sense, when Orietta is like asking about how Italian non-branded company can appealing for such generation, but as I mentioned to you, maybe they are quite flat, but they are also interested in like a split of stories that they can discover more and more by, you know, like typically through the, you know, web platform, Instagram, whatever platform that is like accessible for them. Mm-hmm. So, and also, for example, talking about how to, you know, like involving those generation, I think Chanel, in a sense, is quite aggressive in, you know, for example, they are organizing the game center very pop culture of Japanese, like young kids, they're integrating, such like a game center in their, event. So that, that generation can be, start interested in, the culture that is offered by Chanel. And of course, Chanel has a lot of story to offer. That's, those like big brands, especially French ones, they are, struggling and finding the way to, appealing to those generation. Mm-hmm. And, but that is now because of the cost of the, digital marketing and those digital platform that you can easily access. Like Akiko-san showed this, eco-activist, such approach, even such approach, appealing for them. It's not about using the Taylor Swift, Selena Gomez, It's about, value that is, maybe it's a niche market, but that is appealing to certain market with certain, stories.
Very interesting. I like it that we have very different opinion. And I want to also to announce, which is Akiko-san opinion about this topic.
To be honest, it's not really my field, but I feel like both, Shinichi-san and Shigeki-san opinion, I think Generation Z, they may like quite cheaper ones, buy through the internet. Now we are selling our used clothes in app, in application from our smartphone. So they buy clothes from other people more recently. But the thing is, yes, it's quite quite common for young people. But still, I feel like if there is a story between the clothes, as Shigeki-san said, when you are talking about the leather, I think the story may, change their feeling. Yes. Mm-hmm. It's maybe not because of it's made in Italy or made in Japan or something. Probably maybe the story is going to be more important than, other things compared to before.
Yeah. Very interesting. Very, very interesting. Mm-hmm. So let me jump inside of the last topic, because everyone expects to speak about game culture when we talk about Japan, isn't it? And this is something I really want to share with you, because we've seen that even after the coronavirus lockdown, so some luxury brands, overseas luxury brands, was increasing the gaming culture. And I wanna go directly in this kind of super cool things, the Nintendo Animal Crossing. So, Shinichi, what do you think about?
I read that, this news, American newspaper or something. So, and I knew that this game is called Animal Crossing. So, in Japanese, we call it Atsumare Doubutsu no Mori, Atsumori. So, Atsumori is, Animal Crossing is, very popular, but the last, 3 months, the number of users has increased very sharply in the world. And oh my God, I said, well, wow, that's what I thought. And the next, so that it says that the famous fashion designer, Marc Jacobs and Valentino, that they collaborated with Nintendo Switch, Animal Crossing, and they actually, you can wear, the dresses in the game. So the clothing, that Valentino and the Marc Jacobs for the design for this season. So I said, oh my God, you know, that is the you know, sort of great like a promotion I've never had. You know, the game and the Nintendo and the very high-end fashion like a Valentino and a Marc Jacobs. So that is the pretty, you know, sort of, well, a game is always, you know, sort of has considered sort of as the very important media, but so fashion designers, they didn't use the game as media to communicate with customers. So, but now, you know, so I think, so this is very interesting.
This is very interesting, yes. And I like it to talk about this because in the industry now, everyone are facing how to present themselves using augmented reality, avatars, artificial intelligence, robotics. So this is the topic that everyone are discussing. If they are material company, if they are finished product company in lifestyle, in fashion, and this is really new. It's really a fresh way to start to talk in a different way. So what do you think, Shigeki, about this? Your opinion?
I think, you know, when we are talking about those technology, like I think already more than a decade, people talking about singularity, you know, like when this digital technology and our, you know, like physical existence will merge at some time point of time. But when we are talking about such you know, topics, you know, people are talking and thinking too much about big change and the dramatic change that we can, you know, easily find in Hollywood movies. But actually, you know, what happened after this COVID crisis, and like that's something we can see with this increasing users of the Animal Crossing. I think for the people, it's very difficult to jump into something totally different. But previously, this Animal Crossing was only, you know, collecting fans as game users. But when we are facing this, you know, big, you know, situation, loneliness, you know, lack of the, you know, human touch and human communication, they just suddenly discovered, okay, this is actually the another way of the communication. You know, of course we can do such, you know, communication through the Zoom or, you know, like Teams, Slack, you know, Skype, whatever. But this kind of communication, we have to be on the screen and concentrating, you know, what to wear, what to discuss. That is a little bit, you know, exhausting for the people because we are not, you know, used to it. It's not like naturally we are, you know, like, how should I say, sitting next to each other and feeling existence. And that kind of communication that we cannot do through such, you know, like a communication, you know, method. And suddenly people start to discover, especially maybe starting from the younger generation, this, by using this game, people can share, you know, something similar. And also people can organize an event, people can organize a concert, people can even organize a fashion show. And suddenly, you know, it was just a part of the game previously. But what to wear in this Animal Crossing suddenly become very important because it's part of the communication. What to wear, like people start thinking about the same way that is happening in the physical world. So this is also something similar, you know, like a department stores, for example, facing. You know, this, you know, when you're wearing, you know, Valentino in this Animal Crossing, maybe this person finally can meet with your, or, you know, friend you made in this Animal Crossing. Maybe she also wants to wear the same clothes in the real world. But, you know, so that is kind of singularity people were thinking about and never happened. But actually, suddenly, we are facing through our existing platform as a, you know, by the change of the communication method.
Yes, very interesting. I think really interesting because this is, all of you pointed out the importance of technology, but also the importance of having the physical aspect, the physical elements, and also talking about small business, small brands, or no branded, because I assume it also game, this typology of games can also propose several typology of brands, concept stories. I really like it. I really like it so much to say with you. I knew that I really would like to go through many other topics because I've seen that people were connected, they want to know, they want to listen more. And let me tell you that we were really waiting to have the opportunity to speak with you today. So thank you very much, because I want to conclude this session. And thanks to you so much because you share with us some interesting, let me say, information, opinion, suggestions. I want to thanks also to all of our Linea Pelle community. I want to also say that this is our last Now and Together industry edition, because next week we will start 4 weeks of another interesting adventure, a new point of view, digital edition. So we will see, we will stay again in contact for the next week. I suggest you, Akiko-san, Shigeki-san, Shinichi-san, to follow us, because beauty now it's, we can stay connected, we can follow, and we can stay in touch again. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for having me.
Arigato.
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 Thank you.